Autumn, and weather conditions can be quite changeable at this time of year, this rocky peninsula sticks out into the North Sea just above Filey Bay, and twice each day it is covered by the incoming tide. During low tides, however, the rocks attract numerous birds that find food and shelter amongst the cracks and crevices. Cormorants breed on nearby cliffs, but will use the rocks as places to rest in between bouts of fishing, and occasionally will pass the time with a spot of sunbathing. The smaller shags, on the other hand, are merely winter visitors taking time out from their breeding grounds on the Isle of May or from nearby Flamborough. The retreating tide exposes new feeding opportunities for these oyster catchers. Although they can often be seen playing chicken with the waves while searching the rocks and seaweed for the odd morsel, they are also found probing the soft sands of Filey Bay for worms and shellfish. As the tide ebbs, they gather together in large roosts amongst the rocks where they are safe from predators. Sandwich terns can be seen on the brig during spring and summer, but by September only a few stragglers remain, the rest having departed for southern Europe or Africa. From great heights they dive for fish such as sand eels, sprats and whiting. Sadly, they are prone to human disturbance at their breeding sites, are hunted on their wintering grounds in West Africa, and are vulnerable to egg collecting throughout the tropics. Numerous herring gulls can be seen out at sea or rubbing shoulders with the rafts of eiders and scoters that gather here to feed on the mussels that cling to the rocks. These sea ducks are sometimes joined by flocks of teal that may winter here. The gulls are real opportunists and will take advantage of any food that they may find floating on the surface. Filey has a substantial breeding population, and many of these appear to be young birds. They often gather on the beaches, where they may also be found roosting during the evening. Once considered a rarity, Mediterranean gulls are becoming increasingly common, since their first confirmed breeding in the UK in 1968. Most Mediterranean gulls spend the winter around Sicily, Libya and Tunisia. Turnstones that winter here will return to Greenland or eastern Canada to breed, with some non-breeding individuals hanging on throughout the spring or even the summer. Purple sandpipers will spend the winter months within the subarctic region, but some will turn up on our rocky shores having travelled from perhaps as far away as northern Canada, arriving here amongst the flocks of turnstones and knot. During autumn there can be up to 2,000 knot visiting the brig, although they tend to fluctuate each year, and numbers have been significantly lower in recent times. More often seen probing around muddy estuaries, these long-distance migrants seem to revel in the surf breaking across the rocky brig. During June and July, some of these birds will have been breeding on the Arctic tundra of Greenland or northern Canada, where they will have acquired a deep chestnut plumage, far gaudier than their winter greys. Amongst these post-breeding adults are many juveniles that hatched only a few months ago. The youngsters are the ones with the warmer buff colouring on their breasts. While spar-tailed godwits only turn up in small numbers, dunlin are much more numerous. These tiny waders are really approachable provided you make no sudden movements to unsettle them. Small birds such as these expend so much energy during their migration flights that they need to feed incessantly whenever they land. They are so intent on feeding that they require the appearance of little animated sewing machines. Sometimes, however, the need to rest takes precedent, despite an incoming tide. With bill neatly tucked under a wing and one eye on the tide, it's not easy to get a little shut eye. The adult dunlin that breed on our upland moors have already moved south to Africa, having started their migration in July. These birds are all juveniles and may well be migrants from Scandinavia rather than our own British-bred youngsters. Some of them are already molting into winter plumage, with grey feathers starting to appear on their mantles and scapulars. As molting usually takes place on the wintering grounds, these birds may be staying here for a while. As the sun gets lower in the sky and more rocks begin to be covered by the incoming tide, we are forced to beat a retreat. But the birds of the brig, they will continue to feed for as long as they are able.